God's help, we can do all.
Amen.
I would like to thank the Lord. 26 years ago, I was an alcoholic, and he took that away from me. And the way he done it is he gave me a beautiful little girl. And I made a promise that I was going to quit drinking with his help to see my kids grow up. Well, I've done that. My kids have grown up. My youngest one is Heather. And just last week, she got married.
Oh, praise the Lord.
The little grandbaby is my oldest daughter. And the Lord is blessing me with two good girls.
Praise
the Lord.
Two good son-in-law and a beautiful little grandbaby.
Yes.
And I want to thank him. Got nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
It's all got to do with me.
That's right.
So many times, it was left up to me, I would have failed over the years. But I didn't, because of God's help.
Praise the Lord.
So, if you'll always put God in the middle of everything, it'll always work.
That's right.
Because I don't miss the drink. I wouldn't go back and change it for nothing in the world. Because it's been a blessing to see my two girls grow up and make them grandkids. And one day, if I live long enough, I'd be a great man.
Amen.
If the world stands, that's up to God. Does anybody else have a testimony or anything they want to say or do for the Lord?
David, I'd like to say, Thou art the Lord, and I know what He's done for me many, many, many times. He's touched me.
Mm-hmm.
And I thank God for it. It's been years and years. Saved this young girl, young lady. He's let me live. Be 84 years old now. Cancer and everything else. But God is still on the throne. He still brings you through it. And I can't thank Him enough. No way can I. And I just thank God for what He's done for me. And I've got fine sons, serve the Lord. Got fine grandchildren, serve the Lord. And great-grandchildren that serve. Anything comes up, my youngest grandson, son will be, he said, it's my time for prayer. And you know, when a 10-year-old tells you it's time, you better take notice. I thank God for what He's done for me and the blessings He's given me. I don't know how long or why He's left me here, all this, but He's left me here for a reason, and I know it's to serve Him, and that's my greatest ability, what I want to do. Tell somebody else about Jesus and what He can do, because He can get you out of anything. That I know. We just need to continue. Pray for our pastor and his wife. They need it so bad. We don't know why this has happened. I didn't know why it happened to me and nothing else. But we still need to be on our knees of praying.
Anybody else? Nobody else has got nothing. We'll turn it over to him, bring a message. Y'all give him your attention, pray for him.
Thankful to be here this morning. We've not come to take Brother Tony's place, just to sort of fill in the gap for him. We love Brother Tony and Sister Jackie. They've been blessing our life a long time. We miss them. Prayer before, and I know that y'all have been praying for him and continue to do so. Amen, this morning. But we are glad to be in the Lord's house, and good to see you all. I thought this morning about a dear friend of ours. He's a deacon up at Blue Chapel Church, and he used to work as an appliance maintenance man. He'd go around to different houses, and one special lady he always loved to go see. And every time he'd go up there and knock on the door, he'd take her a long time so to get to the door. She was getting on up in age, and every time she'd open the door, he'd look at her and say, "How you doing?" She'd look at him and say, "About dead, thank the Lord." And that's about the way I am. I'm about dead, thank the Lord, this morning. But I'm thankful to be here anyway, and it's good to see you. And we pray that you'll pray for us. We've been praying for you this morning. God's been good, and I thought about the grandchildren we have, and we've lived. She's got to be pretty old before we've had any grandchildren, but we've got three now, and we're thankful for that. And we hope they grow up to be Christians. I know their daddy taught their mom and dad to be Christians, and I hope that they'll let that spill down onto them through the years. And maybe one day, like the lady said a while ago, when they walk around and see old grandpa and lay there in the casket, they'll remember. Amen. He done his best. Amen. He was in church. Amen. If you have your Bible, we've got a lot of scripture this morning. Genesis chapter 1. We're going to read this in order that we might get the thought across that's on our mind this morning. And it's not a great big thought. If it was, I couldn't handle it, and I still can't handle it no way. But you pray for us, we might get it across to you. We're not going to read all the scripture in the first chapter, but we're going to read a good bit of it that you might understand what we're trying to tell you this morning. God's been good to us in our life, and I can look at you this morning and see he's been good to you and hear your testimonies and understand that you have, God's been good to y'all.
Amen.
And we need to praise him for that, and not only here today on Sunday, but when we get up on Monday morning, we need to thank him for that.
That's
and
right.
When we go to bed on Monday night, we need to thank him for that, and always remember God, because he's the beginning of all things, and he surely will be the ending of all things. Amen. The Bible says this, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. It says, "In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, Let there be light. And there was light, and God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day." Now, God started this whole world by word, just by speaking. And when he did, everything began to come in motion. You remember this, fifth verse, "And the evening and the morning were the first day." And we go down to verse 8. "And God called the firmament of heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day." That's what God did the second day. 13th verse, it said, "Then the evening and the morning were the third day." You go back and you look and see where he created all the seeds and the flowers and the grass. Now we'll go down to verse 19. "And the evening and the morning were the fourth day." You can go look and see how he divided and made the lights into heaven. And all these things, and the evening and the morning were the fourth day. 23rd verse, it said, "And the evening and the morning were the fifth day." You can see when God created the whales and all the living creatures. And all it was perfect. So back then, it was perfect because God had created all new and all fresh. Now we will start reading in the 26th verse. "And God said, Let us make man in our image, and after in our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. "And God blessed them, and God said unto them, Be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. And God said, Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which the fruit of a tree yield the seed. To you it shall be for meat, and to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat, and it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. All right, you may be seated this morning. You go and read the next couple of verses there in the second chapter, you see where God rested on the seventh day from all of his work. Amen. I begin to read this, and I begin to sort of picture back in those days when God created this, everything was perfect. And before man was ever created, everything was perfect. But when God made man and man came into picture, things begin to happen and go wrong. You see, where later on, where God created a garden, Eastward and Eden, and there he put man and woman. Amen. But God created all this. He created the sun and the moon and all the land. He separated it from the water. And everything he looked at, Brother Kenner, he said was good.
Yeah.
But you know, he saved the very best for life. Amen. The very best that God created, he saved for the last day. Preacher, what was that? It was man. The very best that God could have, amen, this whole world was mankind. Amen. It was a good place. It was a wonderful place. Amen. And you know, you can go through the Bible and look at all the scriptures. Amen. There's certain scriptures in there that says that, amen, well, the last thing is better than the beginning of it. Amen. Apostle Paul was a great man. Amen. He went and done great things upon this whole world. He had a good life. Amen. So have I. Amen. So have you. Amen. Today, by your testimonies, amen, you've had a good life. And I'm thankful for that. Amen. Praise the Lord this morning. Amen. But I want to tell you, amen, the end, amen, is going to be better. Amen. Than it is here today. Amen. Well, I don't know how I'm going to leave this walk of life, and neither do you. Amen. This morning. Amen. But just to this, amen, after that last breath, it's going to be better. Oh, yes, it is. It's going to be a good place. Amen. Amen. A place where man, amen, can't get in there. Amen. And corrupt everything. Amen. Because God has got a special place for special people. Amen. Yes, he does. It's going to be better on the other side. Amen. I've heard him say, amen, about Jordan. Amen. I've heard him say, amen, about Beulah Lane. Amen. But praise the Lord. One day I'm going to walk up to Jordan. Amen. I'm not going to look at it. I'm going to cross it. Amen. To the other side. Amen. I'm not going to be saved. Amen. Of Beulah Lane. I can see it afar off. Amen. But glory be to God. I'm going to step on it and walk on it. Amen. Because God promised me a better place. Amen. I love where I live. Down yonder on Highway 11. I do. It's been a home for nearly 66 years. A little spot of ground. Amen. Right there. Amen. I told them this morning. Amen. In Sunday school. Amen. Every time I leave. Amen. I thought always about going back. Amen. To where I come from. Amen. The Bible teaches me. Amen. To God. Amen. Believe in my. Amen. Breathe into my body. A living soul. And ever since. Amen. That day. Ever since that hour. Amen. This soul has been wanting to go back. Amen. To the one that gave it. Amen. Listen to me, folks. Amen. The end of this is going to be better than the beginning. Amen. It will. I promise you, it will. Amen. I promise that it will. Amen. Apostle Paul, amen, like I said a while ago, amen, he had a good life. Amen, after he got saved. Amen, after the road to Damascus, after when God struck him down with blindness, he had a good life. Amen, yes he did. He wound up in prison, I know. He wound up whipped. Amen, with a whip. I know he did. Amen, but every time, amen, that happened, he gave God the praise for it. Amen, because he knew the end of this was going to be better than when he started, amen. That's just true. It is. Oh, let me read you some scripture. Amen. The Apostle Paul, amen, wrote in a couple of places, amen, this morning. Amen. Even after, amen, he had been shipwrecked. Amen. Even after that, amen, he was bitten by that viper. Amen. Even after that, whoa, hallelujah, he was still glad he was saved. Amen. Still glad. Amen. He was ready to meet his maker. Amen. This morning. Amen. God, amen, kept the best for life. Amen. We can shout in church. Amen. We can sing like an angel. Amen. We can pray. Amen. Like the psalmist David. Amen. But you listen, it's going to be better in heaven than it is in church. Amen. Yes. I enjoy church.
Amen.
I love church. Love the people I meet in church. Love to hear the singing to testify. Whoa, I can't hardly imagine. Amen. How that lady will sound up here right now, singing the praises. Amen. Of God. And God sitting back smiling. Amen. Listen to him. Oh, but David, one of these days. Amen. When these old pilgrims. Amen. When these old Gentiles finally make it. Amen. The angels go out and step back. Amen. Listen to you and me. Amen. Sing the glory of God to come. We came. Amen. Not able to see it, but believe it. Amen. Blessed are those who have not seen, but yet they believe. Whoa, hallelujah, this morning. Amen. For us who makes it to the end, the slain shall be slain. Amen. They've got a special place in heaven. Amen. Because God loved us. Amen. Because we ain't never seen him again, we believe him. Amen. The end of it's going to be better than it was when we started. I'll be honest with you. Amen. When I got saved, I really didn't know what happened. I sort of grew into it. Amen. I heard the preacher preach. Amen. The Spirit of God convicted my soul. I came to the altar. I bowed my head. Amen. When I got up, I felt like I've changed. I felt like I've been saved. Amen. But I didn't know nothing about the Bible. I was a young man. Didn't know nothing about it. Amen. Well, when you listen to me this morning, amen, later on, I begin to grow in the scriptures, and I begin to realize, amen, I'm on a journey, amen, where it is better, amen, than where it was when I started. Amen, you listen today, amen, Apostle Paul, amen, he loved life, he lived, amen, for Jesus, he was glad when God put him, amen, the preacher to the Gentiles, and you listen today, if you can come back, amen, and do it all over, I believe you would, amen, but you listen, he's happy where he is today, amen. I believe old Paul's happy. Amen. Even in hanging upside down.
Yes.
Amen. I believe old Paul's happy. Praise the Lord this morning. You listen to what he said. Amen. Book of Ephesians. Philippians. Book of Philippians. Chapter 1. Amen. Paul said this in the 20th verse. He said, according to my earnest expectation and my hope, that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but that which all with all boldness, as always, will now also Christ shall be magnified in my body, whether it be by life or by death. Therefore, to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Whoa, praise the Lord. Amen. How can we gain anything? Amen. In death. Amen. I'll tell you. Amen. All heaven got. Amen. Is our hands. Amen. When we step out of this world. Amen. Believing in Jesus. Everything that God ever created of better is in our welcome. Amen. This morning. Preacher, will they know me? Amen. Everybody, you never meet a stranger in heaven. You'll be brothers and sisters in the Lord, and they'll know you as you know in Christ Jesus. Amen. We can be happy whoever we walk up to see. They'll be kin to us. The blood of Christ covers our sins. We're all a part. Amen. Of Jesus. Amen. This morning. Oh, thank you, Lord. Amen. I tell you what, I don't believe Paul was a rich man. Amen. I don't believe he had much. Amen. But what he had was what he needed. Amen. This morning. We searched for treasures down here, but thank God you listened to me. Our treasures are up yonder. Amen. Where the moth and rust are not corrupt, and thieves can't break through and steal. Amen. Our treasures are up yonder in glory. Amen. Thank God it's better on the other side. We just need to hold on till the end. Amen.
Amen.
So many quit before they ever get to the end. And that's a shame.
That's right.
It's just a plump shame. Amen. They'll make it nearly there and the queen. Amen. But you listen to what Paul said. But if I live in the flesh, this is the fruit of my labor. Yet what I shall choose, I want not. Says, for I am in a strait betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to meet with Christ, which is far better. Nevertheless, to abide in the flesh is more needful for you. Amen. Well, Paul had been close enough, hallelujah, that he was able to get to where, amen, he wanted to go to a better place. Amen. One place the Bible says, amen, he saw a vision, amen, of the third heaven. Amen. He couldn't tell where it was or what it was. Amen. But every time, amen, he thought about that place, he wanted to go back to it. Amen. This morning, once you ever get to Calvary, amen, once you ever in a visual, amen, a spiritual vision, see Jesus, amen, on your knees in prayer, you'll always want to go to where he is. Amen. There's nothing like it. Nothing like being a Christian and being with Jesus. Amen. Oh, well, Paul enjoyed his preaching life. Amen. It wasn't no burden for him. Amen. He enjoyed, amen, his journey and this walk of life with Jesus. But thank God he knew it was far better on the other side.
Yes,
won't be nobody persecuting him. Won't be nobody throwing him in prison. Nobody whipping him. And listen to me, individual. It's going to be better over yonder. I guarantee you. Amen. It'll be better over yonder. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 6 says, for I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. He said this to Paul, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Now, we all got to do that. We've all got to be like Apostle Paul. We've got to finish his course and have kept the faith. He said, henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me, hallelujah, at that day. And not to me only, but to all them also that love his appearing. Amen. Can you imagine sitting here at Ebenezer Church in the year 2017, just they hardly got much of nothing, I don't hope. One day after a while, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords walks around that great big table that he's got,
yeah,
and places that crown of righteousness,
that's
on a little boy's head. There better be somebody there holding me down. Brother, I man can't stand it out here when he comes by and touches me. Amen. With the Spirit. Amen. Much less up there. He give me a crown of righteousness and lays it on my head. Hallelujah. You talking about shouting and jumping. You better get used to it down here, because that's all I'm going to be up under. Amen. I won't be the first one, because the first one, amen, he'll be a shouting and jumping. Hold down the line, hold down the table, win and women, amen, all the way down. Amen, there'll be a jumping and a shouting. And finally, when you get to me, I'll just join in the chorus, and we'll all shout and jump around, maybe for 1,000 years, I don't know. What difference does it make?
That's right.
We ain't going to give out. What difference does it make? The Lord ain't going nowhere. You ain't going nowhere. The end of this will be better than the start of it. Amen. He has saved the best for last all through time. He shows us that we need to have patience. the very last hour was coming, it's coming, it will come. Talk about that soon as we. Very last minute, I don't know when it is, but it's coming. But I want you to keep this in your heart. It's going to be better after that. I don't know what's going to happen. Ever since God created man, it's been going downhill.
Right.
He put him in a perfect place, a beautiful place. They take a while to get that corrupted and get thrown out. The Garden of Eden ain't going to be nothing to what's going to be in heaven. Everything up there, ain't going to be no dust on it.
That's right.
There ain't going to be no storm clouds. There ain't going to be no hinges on the doors creaking when you hold them. Don't have to worry about the power going off. The power always be on.
Yes.
This is what sort of tickled me, it may sound silly. But I won't have to go out in the yard and pick up leaves. sort of silly, don't it? Mm-hmm. But this is what can happen for just a minute. You don't have to pay to get the grass cut. See, it'd be any better. Mm-hmm. You don't have to get gas to go to Walmart. Car won't have to flat and get up and get ready to go. In a crying day, you have to work on it. You ladies, 5 years ago, we had a hole, something torn in a pair of pants or a shirt. You can go get a new one, you just have to put pants on it. And nobody would be stuck with a toe if we're falling down and bleeding. That's not what hell will do. But if you don't think you'll be better over him, you can talk to me when I get to the house. He saved the best for the last. It's appointed that the man wants to die, and after this, the judgment. Well, that's all over. If you've been true to the Lord, you've trusted in him, you've kept the faith, you've finished the course, there's henceforth something laid up for you, a crown of righteousness. You fail into this, you're going to adjust God's hands. They can put you where you're supposed to be. I'll put it like that. He may not put you where you want to go, but he'll put you where you're supposed to be. Now, the vice versa of this, this is a whole lot better place than hell. I know to be fixing a flat tire in 110 degree weather. Well, something beat down on my head, with nothing to wipe the sweat off all around with it. Then I can go to hell.
Yes.
I done work in a steel mill, throwing chunks of steel in the furnace. I have an aluminum factory. I done been doing that on the hottest day of the year. And tonight I can go to hell.